Hi, I'm Greg Hallett, and I'm here again with Erin Bates. And we talked in a previous segment about her background and how her music has developed over her life. And I mentioned I'm a big admirer of the things that she does because I wasn't doing them when I was her age. For whatever reason, I didn't have the opportunities to learn some of the things that she's learned. And so we talked a little bit about that. I want to take a few minutes and talk about her CDs, her recording process. This is another thing that she was doing or is doing that I would never have thought about doing when I was 20. As a matter of fact, I was barely playing the piano at 20. And so I wanted to talk just a little bit about that. You have out one CD that's selling very well. You told me on the way that it's selling very well. And at least I think it's selling well. And you have another one in the process.
Yes, it's almost done. Hopefully a couple weeks.
Okay.
We're looking at.
So it's going to launch in May? Or
hopefully the end of May.
Okay, and the first one, what was the title?
Merciful and Mighty.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And how long ago was that?
I guess it was about a year, maybe a little over a year.
Okay, so tell me about that. Tell me what you wanted to accomplish with that CD and how you got from that initial thought to a studio actually doing it.
Okay, well, my dad had always wanted me to record a CD. And so I tried once, but it was more of like a home record, so it wasn't as professional. But I had a whole lot of songs, but a lot of more different styles.
Uh-huh.
So I knew I wanted the CD to be like a certain style. I didn't want it to be just like a variety of styles.
Uh-huh.
So I tried to get a lot of arrangements that were kind of compatible together.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't want them to all be the same because as an arranger, I have a tendency to use a lot of the same runs or a lot of the same patterns. Or so I wanted to, you know, go out of my box that I usually am in and go a little farther out. And I don't know. It worked out. I recorded a few more, but we limited it, narrowed it down to those.
Okay, so talk about, you chose the songs. Mm-hmm. What style were you going after?
I don't really know the name of it, but it's like, it has a lot of classical in it.
Is it the Bates style?
I guess so. I don't know. I guess it doesn't really have a name.
Okay.
But
it's what you're looking for.
Kind of lyrical.
So what is the purpose? What is the purpose that drives recording? Which is not the easiest thing in the world to do. Sort of pressure packed. Why did you do it?
Well, I know I did my first CD for Dad,
uh-huh.
but I know it helps me to remember the arrangements because I just haven't had the time to transcribe them yet.
Uh-huh.
But, and I know it's been an encouragement to other people, and a lot of people ask me to, so I guess I do it for them too.
So, okay, so tell me about, how did you pick a producer? How did that process go?
Okay, well, I heard about a producer at the college I was going to. He'd done a lot of their work.
And that was Jason.
It was Jason, yes, yeah. Jason Prisk. And I knew that he was a Christian, and he knew a lot of the songs I was going to be doing, so he was already familiar with it. And a lot of the other producers I had talked to, they're like, well, you don't know a lot of sacred stuff. But so I wanted him to be familiar with what I was playing and the style I wanted, and I knew he was familiar with that. So that's how I picked him.
Okay, so you went to Nashville in
yes.
the studio. What yes. studio again?
Went to Playground Studios in Nashville.
Right.
And it is great studio.
Okay, so talk to me about the process. You go in there. How many days did you spend on it?
Okay, 2 days.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And how did it go?
Well, when I went there, I wasn't completely prepared because I do a lot of stuff and it never sounds the same the second time you play it, you
uh-huh.
know? But I went there and I was a little nervous. So it took me, I guess for the first hour, it just wasn't turned out. So I was really flustered. I'm like, this isn't going to work because I'm so nervous, you know? Because if you're playing and thinking about, oh my goodness, so many people are going to hear this, and when you record, it's like putting it under a microscope,
uh-huh.
so it's scary too. But
it is,
I think I had to adjust to the studio, and it was relaxing after that. And I was just like, just play, and it worked a lot better after. I would get used to the atmosphere and the piano too. So
tell me about the relationship you have with Jason today.
Okay,
he's probably watching. So be done.
Hey, Jason. No, he did great. He gave me some ideas and critiques, you know, some, and it was perfect is what I wanted. I want somebody to critique me and say, change that. That doesn't sound good. Or change this.
Is he good at that?
He's very good at it. He is.
Yeah, I'm sort of making fun. I'm lightly making fun of Jason because Jason has produced all my music.
He's very good.
I know exactly what Jason's like to work in the studio. He's very, and he's a person that will tell you if it's...
He's perfectly honest.
Yeah, he's very good. And I can remember many times I would finish something and I thought it was pretty good. And Jason would, I'd say, what'd you think? Not very good. And he'll just tell you that. And did you ever want to hit him?
Oh, sometimes I'd be like so discouraged. I'm like, oh my goodness, if this isn't, if Jason thinks this doesn't sound good, can you imagine what everybody else is thinking? But no, I was so grateful for it in the end. But I guess Darren, I was like, why doesn't this sound good? This is fancy, you know?
Yeah, and, but he's like, and that's exactly, like you said, that's exactly what you want in the studio.
Yeah,
you, somebody to be
you
honest.
Do, you do, yes.
And that's why I've used him for 5, 6 projects now.
Yes.
Because I know that he, in the end, even though, be honest with you, many times I want to kill him. but yeah,
I didn't say that.
Okay, well, we'll edit that out later. But yeah, I mean, it's a very, very tense, pressure packed experience.
Because you feel like you have to get so many done, and you only have this time slot, and yeah, it's kind of tense, but you have to work with it.
Do you tell me really quick that you came out? Tell me the name again. It was great. What was the first
Merciful
project?
And Mighty.
Merciful and Mighty, and that's available where?
You can get it off of our website, and it's www.gilbatesfamily.com.
They can order on there?
Yes, you can. It's like on the home screen here.
And then the next one, how are you going to announce it?
We will announce it on the website, but I think it's going to be on the show too, so.
Oh, tell me real quick about, you worked with Andy Leftwich.
Oh, yes.
Andy is a, how many Grammys does he have?
I think 4.
That's 4 more Grammys than me.
And, me too.
Yes. 4 more than us combined. But Andy, you hooked up with Andy at a, how did y'all?
We went to his church.
Okay.
When I was recording my first project.
Uh-huh.
And he was there, and he just had his fiddle with it. I'm like, oh, are you a fiddler? He's like, yeah, I am. I'm like, do you do that for a living? He's like, yeah, I do. I'm like, who do you play for? And he went on to say he played for Ricky Skaggs. I'm like,
yeah.
Oh my goodness. And he had somehow seen our Family on the Duggars show, and he wanted to get together for supper that night. And it worked out that he came to the studio instead to get together, and he had his fiddle. So I'm like, will you record on one of the songs? And he was so happy too. So I was so honored that he would. He's a great guy.
And you used him on a lot more on the next project?
The next CD, he's on every song except for one. So
wow.
He's
okay.
On, yeah.
Yeah, I've used him as well. It's it's great. Great.
Oh, with. He's amazing to work with.
Yeah. So look for that CD. It's coming out in June.
Hopefully May.
May.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
And I'll try to announce it when it comes out on my
That'd
blog
be
as
awesome.
Well. Thanks so much. We'll talk in the next segment about music. Play some. We'll play some.
Okay. Sounds good.